All right, February 24th, Ashland, Nebraska. Coming south right now off the Sioux City Sub is a manifest, most likely from Sioux City, Iowa, to Hobson Yard. Southbound, and now he's swinging west onto the Heartland Division. The signals for him have been lit for a while here. So unlike Fremont, when the signals come on, the train's there, you know, 5, 10, 15 minutes later. Here, the signals are approach lit, but they'll light up and tell you something's coming, but usually takes a little while for them to show up. It's the only bad thing about being in Ashland. You'll know they're coming, you just don't know when. There are loads of ethanol. Most likely from the ADM plant up there. In Sioux City. He's on the western leg of the Y. This particular train should go into Hobson Yard and be broken up on the hump there. There comes one of the new coil cars from Trinity Rail. There. big gondolas at the end. Band of the West here. This comes out, the Heartland Division. Ralph Fanning Adventures, Ashland, Nebraska.
Alright, after a bit of a wait, February 24th, here in Ashland, westbound empty coal drag.
Mega, two trains in one. RWSX, the recording mark from the east. Sandhill Division into Wyoming.
Ralph Fanning Adventures, Ashland.
Alright, February 24th, Ashland, Nebraska. Coming west out of Omaha. Onto the Heartland Division. Looks like it's going to be a manifest. Gibbson Yard when I was in Omaha, so
Adventures, Ashland, Nebraska.
Alright, February 24th, I'm here in Ashland, Nebraska at the Y. And here comes an eastbound empty coal drag. Or westbound, sorry. The leader. CAE. Coal heading to the Powder River Basin. Still live for something coming south off the Sioux City sub. Directly in front of me. Another empty westbound coal drag. February 24th, Ashland, Nebraska. Here comes a eastbound. Passing me here at the Y. We got a green for a westbound. This one here is an eastbound. Looks like a unit train of grain going by. Second unit was a dash 9. These are empty. you. Yeah, we got a green for westbound. Another dash line.
As you can see over here, we got a high green. Which means another train's coming.
Alright, February 24th, still sitting here in Ashland. That eastbound just went by, that train of empty corn. Here comes a empty coal drag heading west. JSCX. Adventures, Ashland, Nebraska. All right, February 24th, 2023. I'm sitting here in Ashland. And this eastbound coming out of us just went all the way over to the right and will be swinging north and start its journey north up the Sioux City sub. Looks like possible unit train of ethanol or crude. Should have some foreign power on it, possibly. Easily we'll catch CN or CP heading north, being as have power here. The Sioux City sub takes them up into Minnesota, Wisconsin, up there. I mean, they can go north, east, and west once they get up there. Get a lot of Canadian Pacific coming down from there, sometimes CN. Looks like we got three units up front and a buffer. Let us zoom in and see what's going on here. I don't know why it's not, there we go, now we're focusing. Tracks just switched in front of us too. Sounds like we're gonna have something going into Omaha next. Now, looks like all BNSF up front. Two buffer cars. One Looks like it's an old CVQ. Could be wrong. Looks like an old CVQ coal porter. Now use a buffer service. And I believe this is not ethanol, but crude. Most likely empties going back up north to get loaded up there in North and South Dakota. Or up into Canada. Again, this one just came off the Heartland Division and now is swinging a north, starting its journey north on the Sioux City sub. And this is heading north now on the western leg of the Y here in Ashland, swinging north onto the beginning of the Sioux City sub, coming off the Heartland Division. Surprisingly, there's no rear DPU on this. Which means they're definitely empty. While the buffer cars are up front. I'm thinking most likely empty crude. It could be ethanol, empty ethanol, but I'm thinking this is the crude train. About six of them. Three southbound, three northbound to go up and down this line, so. Believe it is the crude train. Empty crude. Passing the signal there for the eastern leg of the Y. Maybe my phone's having a hell of a time focusing. Alright guys, I'm doing the best I can. And that is the northbound. And the switches here just switch for something either going into or coming out of Omaha. So
That should be along shortly. Real Fanning Adventures, Ashland, Nebraska.
Alright, 24th of February. I'm here in Fremont, and it's that northbound unit train. I call it an Ashland, going north, and it is empty ethanol. Not crude, empty ethanol. Caught this one coming off the Heartland Division, swinging north on the Sioux City sub. Here it is on the Sioux City sub, about to cross Union Pacific Transcon line here in Fremont as it continues northbound with its empty ethanol cars. It was not crude. I videoed this earlier. I thought it would be an empty crude train. It is ethanol. Fremont, Nebraska. Great place to see both BNSF and Union Pacific. This is BNSF's Sioux City sub. Behind me is Union Pacific Transcon line and the former C&W main line. UP either goes into Omaha or bypasses Omaha through Blair, heading to Chicago. Videoed this earlier. I thought it was an empty crude train. It is not. It is empty ethanol heading north. Flammable 3, 1987, denatured ethanol. These, of course, are empties. Another way you can tell out here, if it was loaded, there'd be a buffer car and a rear DPU. They got both buffer cars on the front behind the three engines and just the DOT at the end. Rail Fanning Adventures, Fremont, Nebraska. And there goes the westbound off the former C&W line. Yep, coming off the former C&W line onto the Transcon line here in Fremont, Nebraska. Decent power in the front of this. It should be pretty big. Again, this is heading westbound. It's coming off the former C&W main line, the Blair Fremont sub, onto Union Pacific Transcon. Pretty short for that much power on the front.
There it goes. Westbound.
Real Fanning Adventures. Fremont.